فعاش القلب إخلاصا وصرت تحوم كالطير تحلق في ثقافات وتنهل من ربى الخير.
In fact, there is one degree lower than that, but I don't believe a true mu'min would do that. And that is those who go out to discourage others from salah.
وَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنْ مَنَعَ مَسَاجِدَ اللَّهِ أَنْ يُذْكَرَ فِيهَا اسْمُهُ وَسَعَى فِي خَرَابِهَا.
Who can there be more oppressive than the one who blocks people from the houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And he strives and struggles to actually destroy the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah not do that to us. You know, in Surah Iqra, Allah says,
أَرَأَيْتَ الَّذِي يَنْهَى عَبْدًا إِذَا صَلَّى.
Speaking about Abu Jahl and others of his qualities. What does Allah say? Do you see the one who is stopping a slave from reading salah when he's trying to prostrate to Allah? And Allah is admonishing and Allah is making clear that that is criminal behavior. So that's the worst. In fact, I want to give an example. Something's come to my mind. Moments ago I said I don't think any one of us can be from that. I don't think we would intentionally do it. But do you know how we unintentionally do it? Sometimes in our company, there is a person who's bothered about salah. But because we are bigger numbers, and perhaps the person might not be strong enough to say things sometimes, especially the youth and the youngsters, and those who are adolescent and perhaps growing up. And then we tell him, ah, come on, you can read your salah later, let's go. And he wanted to read his salah. We say, no, you can go, let's just go, carry on. And then we made him miss his salah. So one, for me not to have fulfilled my salah is a sin. But for me to have blocked someone else from fulfilling salah is an even bigger sin. Give you another example. You see the dress code. Sometimes there are people who dress appropriately. But because we are role models in society, people look at us and what do? They say, I want to be like that. So after they were dressed appropriately, because of us, they removed what they had. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may forgive us for what we did to ourselves. But what did you do to others? Allah put you in a position where the higher you are, the more influential you are, the more people look up to you, the more responsible you are for your behavior and for what you do and say. And this is why we say, my brothers and sisters, it is part and parcel of the ummah. We support one another, we love one another, we encourage one another. The little nitty-gritties we've had, the little small, you know, mishaps, or should I say, the small misunderstandings we've had, there comes a day when they become bygones. They become, okay, by the way, okay, you know, in 1960 we had this issue. You cannot keep it all the way up to 2014. Come on. Allahu Akbar. It's gone, it's a bygone. Come on, haven't we grown up enough to see a bigger picture? We have. Subhanallah. There are people trampling over the entire ummah. At least we are sitting together, we love one another. Wallahi. Subhanallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us. So do not be from amongst those whom, when Allah has given you the ability, the capacity, that you go around discouraging people directly or indirectly. May Allah forgive us, really. The last thing I would want, and may Allah really and truly make me conscious of this, because the last thing I would want for myself or for anyone else is to get into the grave and find that, okay, I didn't perhaps commit major sin directly myself, but the way I acted on earth is such that I encouraged others directly or indirectly, and now I'm being nailed because of what they did. And that can happen, because the Prophet ﷺ says, "Man sanna sunnatan sayyatan, falahu wizruha, wa wizru man amila biha ila yawm al-qiyamah." Whoever sets a bad example, they get the sin of it, and of anyone who follows it up to the last day, the day of Qiyamah. May Allah forgive me and forgive everyone else. So become strong when you become a powerful person. And even if you're just a mother in the home, sometimes, and wallahi, in a lot of homes, I'm not too sure of this particular country, but I do know of people who send me a lot of emails from elsewhere and tell me, I tried to dress appropriate and my father stopped talking to me. My mother told me not to do so, and so on. And they suffer. And people say, I try to read salah and really my father doesn't want me to. Allahu musta'an. May Allah safeguard us. May Allah help such people and help us. Imagine your child, you say, no, it's too soon. Don't wear a scarf, too soon. How old are you? 10. 10? How many kids have died at 11? 10? 9? What do you know? What do you know? May Allah never do that to us.